probably 98% of society are good-hearted people that are willing to work with you if you give them a good reason on why they should. The other 2% are already in prison or on their way. But for the most part, these people that are coming into the store, they're nice people, but they're afraid based off the things that they've read, the things that they've heard. Do you know if you go to Google right now and you Google how to avoid being ripped off buying a car, you would be blown back by the amount of videos, the books, the articles that literally teach people how to avoid being ripped off. And little do they realize, all it's really doing is teaching the customer how to make the process that much more difficult on themselves. And who do you think writes these blogs and makes these videos and puts this information out on how to avoid being ripped off buying a car? Who do you think does that?
The ones who got ripped off.
Typically, it's not even a customer who got ripped off. Typically, it's a customer who didn't get what they wanted. They got everything as far as they got, but they wanted some extra floor mats thrown in and they didn't get it, so now they're going to take it to Google, give a bad review, and put a video up. Or they came in, hadn't paid their car note on time for 3-4 months, wanted this particular payment. The bank said there's no way we'll let them drive off without them paying this. They're pissed at you. It's easier to be mad at you instead of themselves. Okay? So this is what you're up against, and I highly encourage you, go online and look and see what these people are seeing. And you'll understand why when the customer comes in, they like to play poker. Meaning, show me what you got and I'll tell you what I want. Well, how can I show you what I have if I don't know what you're interested in? The last thing I want to do is waste your time. I'm sure you have a lot of important things to do. So the more information you share with me, the quicker I can get you the information that you feel will help you. So help me help you. You have to be willing to educate people on, you know, okay, I'm willing to show you whatever you feel works for you. But how can I show you anything if I have no idea of what it is that you're interested in? But this is where they learn it from. Don't give any number. Don't do this, don't do that. And it's all bull, but you need to be prepared to at least know what you're up against, okay? Now, the type of people that come in, they're typically in 4 different personality segments. So in your packet, flip to the page that looks like that one, with the personality trait. Okay, now the first personality trait is what you call the socializer. Now the socializer is your ideal customer. This is somebody that comes in that's willing to speak, but they know what they want. So they know what it is that they're interested in, and they're willing to answer questions and share information with you. Again, your ideal person. The next one you have is the director. Now, the director is somebody that is very self-contained, tight-lipped, but they know what they want. Many people refer to it as the A-type personality. This is the person who say, hey, listen, no, don't ask me any questions. Just show me what you got on this, okay? Now, when you deal with somebody who has that A-type personality that wants to be in control, your objective is to get them to be more social and to be willing to share information, and you do this by asking questions and through genuine compliments, okay? Any egotistical person loves compliments. The quickest way to knock a chip off somebody's shoulder is to have them to take a bow. So you find something relatable about that person that you can compliment them about, genuinely, not something fake. And I believe everybody has something that we can compliment them about very easily. And that comes across very genuine, okay? Now the next person you have is the thinker, okay? Now the thinker is somebody that wants all the information and analytics and all of this stuff, and they gotta go home and think about it, pray about it, stew on it. They gotta talk to their mamas, their daddies, their sisters, their brothers, and then they still might come back and want even more information. Your objective is to convert them into somebody that's willing to take action. Okay? Now the last one we got is the relator. Now that's the customer that'll come in and sit there and talk to you for hours about everything going on except the vehicle. Everything. And you sitting there like, my God. I know my managers are wondering what the hell I'm doing over here. Man, with them, you have to learn how to be what I call politely abrupt. Where you say, look, ma'am or sir, I know your time is valuable. You probably got a lot more important things to do than just sit here and just, you know, because we can do this all day. Let me get back to seeing what it is I can do that'll help you find whatever it is you're looking for. This is somebody you have to steer back, because keep in mind and always remember this. You can't close what you can't control. Okay? And he or she who is asking questions is in control. Why is the person who's asking questions in control?
They're directing the conversation.
They direct the conversation. Now, what does that mean when your customer starts asking you questions? Who just assumed control? They did, right? Now, I'm just throwing this out there. Knowing that whoever he or she who is asking questions is in control, and your customer, let's say they ask you a question, they're interested in a particular vehicle, y'all just started talking and whatnot, and they say, hey, what type of payments would I be looking at on this car, or on this truck, or on this SUV, or on this minivan? Now, they just ask you a question, and he or she who asks questions is in control. So when they ask you, what type of payments are they looking at on this, how can you regain control? Say that louder.
What kind of payment are you looking for?
What type of payments are you looking for? Because here's what most salespeople do. Hey, what type of payments am I looking at? Oh, you know, yeah, it's probably $20 for every 1,000. Or, you know, you'd probably be around $400 or $500. Guess they heard you say $400. And when it comes out at $785, guess what? Now you're a liar. Don't give information, okay? They ask you a question. Answer it with the question. What type of payments are you looking for? And we'll see what we can do about it.
The training was phenomenal, not just for being in the car business and car salesman, but just for life in general, learning different sales techniques and focusing more on the customer and not the sales. So honestly, this is probably the best training I've had ever.
The training was fabulous, but the best part of it was the motivation and the confidence that I'm walking away with.
It's one of the more intense training programs I've ever been through, through the various sales positions I've held, but it's definitely, I feel more comfortable going into it now than I have with any other job, so it's a fantastic training.
Nobody ever taught me how to maximize my time. Nobody ever taught me the proper process to be able to help people a lot faster. Nobody had helped me transform my mentality to realize 40 hours, you put in the time that you have to put in until you get your goal accomplished. But through the years of being around good mentors that I met, doing trial and error, investing thousands of dollars in books and training programs to elevate myself where I was moving 30 units a month, to elevate myself to the point that after years of working in my dealership, I sold my way out and now travel all around the United States to train and educate people how to perform. And if I haven't been to your dealership, I'm about to come to your dealership right now, because in the description, there's a link in the description, and I know how people are. They want to watch the video, jump off, and go. But the fact that you're still here listening says that there's something in here for you. The link in the description will carry you over to a page, to my website or my blog, and it'll list out all of the resources that have been developed over the years of all the trial and error. I took all the error and left all the good for you. The word track to help you ask questions, qualify, do powerful, dynamic presentations. The information, the videos and audios to help you drive hundreds of people from your Facebook, from your Snapchat, from your Instagram to you looking to buy. The 100 success tips to keep you motivated and driven through tough times. How to dominate YouTube. All of these things are available to you. So click the link in the description. Go get started, and you and I work together.